guys, welcome back to another video. Today I want to give you a little tour of my balcony garden at the end of summer. I didn't make any tour in August because honestly my garden looked exactly the same in August as it did in July, so I thought there was no purpose in repeating the same stuff. But now that we are at the beginning of September and we are in between summer and autumn, I think it's a good moment to just take a last look on the balcony in its summer version, because in the next tour I will probably have some fall decorations and fall compositions. I'm actually planning to do a major cleanup this week. I want to get rid of all of my annual flowers and to just get the space ready for planting bulbs and fall flowers. Because I'm leaving for 3 weeks, so when I will come back in October, I want the space to be ready for planting. But of course, if your annual flowers still look amazing, there's no point in getting rid of them. Just enjoy them until they start to die on their own. So yeah, let's go. Let me show you how the things are looking at the end of summer. Okay, I'm starting at the back of the balcony. Not much has changed in here. I just brought my Japanese maple in here because I didn't like it back there where it was at first, because it has a really finely cut leaves, and I think that because the background is so noisy we can't really see this plant very well. But when I turn the other direction, when I look at it from this angle, I think that we can see it better because of the white background and there's less going on in here. And especially in the fall when it will have a beautiful bright red color, I think it will really pop with the white building in the background. Other than that, not much has changed in here. I just have a bunch of herbs that I have to harvest. I have some mint, chives and basil. I will harvest them, I will dry them and use them in infusions and as spices. And here there's just a bunch of randomly placed plants. I honestly didn't do much in here, I just placed a bunch of plants. I didn't have time to just put them in some nice compositions and stuff, and as I said, I'm gonna get rid of annual flowers this week, so I just didn't want to start to change things now. I will do some better compositions in fall when I will plant some nice seasonal fall flowers. This little corner here, this little grouping of pots, I kind of like it. I enjoy this scabiosa very much. I didn't expect it will bloom so beautifully. I mean, I knew that scabiosa can tolerate pirate shade, but honestly I didn't expect much from it during the first year, and it has a lot of blooms and it blooms non-stop and bees absolutely love it. They come here every day, so that's always a winner. And the same with Nepeta. When I repotted it, it looked kind of dead, but now that it has fresh soil and the soil retains more moisture, I start to see some flowers which I haven't seen all summer long. But I'm expecting that because it's a perennial plant, next summer it should do much better than it does now. Really love this Hukura as well. I like how frosty the leaves look, the fresh leaves. It is damaged a bit by vine weevils. So I will have to apply nematodes this fall because I'm sure that I will have full of vine weevil grubs everywhere. And snapdragons also is their second flash of blooms. They are not amazing, but yet again it's a perennial plant, so I'm sure that next summer they will do great, because already now they look not that bad. There's still some new flower buds, so really beautiful, really like this one. Also, you might remember that I had my eucalyptus in here that I got rid of because the weirdest thing happened. I went on holidays and my eucalyptus died, so I replaced it with this Japanese maple that I had in the back of the balcony. Okay, moving this direction, the annual planters, as you can see, they look pretty tired. I lost a bunch of plants because of the heat and the draft. Some of them look amazing, like for example, the Dichondra silver falls just spills from the pot. Impatience, now that it's a little bit colder and more rainy, the impatiens just started to bloom like crazy. They look amazing. And the begonia, the little one on the floor, just keeps blooming non-stop all summer long. And here again I just have a bunch of plants grouped together, not any particular composition in here, because there used to be the Japanese maple in here that provided height, so I am searching for some new plant to add in here just to add some vertical interest. But I didn't find anything interesting yet, so just a random grouping. I repotted one of my hydrangeas, the big pink macrophylla, into a larger container. I used to have another hydrangea here that I removed because I really didn't like how it grew. I had it 3 years and it was just looking messy and unruly and I didn't like it. In this corner here, also I am planning a major change in here. I bought this Taxus baccata that I'm gonna talk about in a moment, but let's just take a moment to look at this clematis. I repotted it like 3 months ago, and it was the clematis itself, when I repotted it, it was literally two branches like this. And now look at this, all of this new fresh growth. It's growing like crazy. And the best part is that there's only one stem growing from the base. All of this growth comes just from one stem. How amazing is that? It's a Clematis Montana variety Maylene. It will have beautiful pink flowers in spring. So what I'm thinking, because it is so long already, I actually bought some clips. Let me just move around, move a little bit backwards so that I can explain better. Here is how it looks. And I cannot mount anything on the wall permanently. So what I bought, some little clips. They are supposed to be delivered today. So I'm hoping at the end of this video I can include clips of what I'm gonna do with it. So my idea is I'm gonna attach some clips and I'm gonna make it climb. I'm gonna make it climb above the window because it is a quite large climbing plant. So I want it to fill this entire wall. I want this entire wall to be full of pink blooms, and I'm gonna clip it so that it goes all above this window in my bedroom here and above the here, the living room window. I want the entire wall to be full of clematis flowers. I think it will look amazing. Okay, you guys, so the clips did arrive and I just finished attaching my clematis to the wall. I'm very satisfied with the result. And I'm gonna show you, the clips look like this. They have adhesive side, both sides are adhesive, and they are really, like, I'm pulling them quite strong and they stay attached. And how it works, so you just put the clematis or any climbing plant for that matter in this little space here, and you close it by twisting these two parts together, so this way the vine or the climbing plant can't escape. And they were super cheap, like 86 cents or so for 10, so that's a great bargain, and I'm really happy with the result. Once the clematis start to fill in, it will look a little bit better than now, but I already love it. As I said, I'm gonna train it to go above the windows, both this one and this one. And just one thing that I wanted to say is that clematis will not damage the surface of the wall. It's not like ivy, heterohelix, for example, that has adventitious roots that attach to the surface. Clematis has twisting petioles. As you can see, the petiole is a leaf stem, so this part between the main stem and the leaves. And as you can see, it twists. So whenever it finds a surface or support, as you can see here, it will just twist around it. So that's what it's gonna do, probably around these clips, and it's not gonna attach itself to the wall. So if one day I want to remove it, that wouldn't be any problem. I just have to cut it down. Other than that, I have this begonia that has a very flashy pink blooms. I also repotted some plants in here. I have this coprosma that looks a really pretty. It is bright red in winter. I really love it, but in summer it has those variegated, slightly pink tinged leaves. Another snapdragon and some hellebore. And that's how this corner looks. And in this corner I'm also planning a major change. So here I'm thinking that I will remove this last pot, and I think I will put some sort of privacy screen in here, like a wooden privacy screen, and may even buy something tall enough to just go like this and to cover this entire wall. Because I don't know if you have seen in my last videos, my neighbor is like spying on me 10 times a day, and she doesn't care about flowers. She just looks directly into my windows, and you know, whenever someone comes over, she spies and all that. So I just need some privacy here. So I'm thinking that I will put some privacy screen. I also bought this Taxus baccata, which is an evergreen plant, and I used to have blue spruce in here that died because of the cytosphora canker. So I was searching for some new evergreen, and Taxus baccata is really nice. It can support full sun and full shade, so it's gonna be perfect here. It looks wild. It was prone to grow in a pillar shape, or rather column shape, and I want to make it more into a tree. So I'm gonna prune the bottom of it. I wanna have a clear trunk, And then I'll try to shape it into more of a tree form, which will take some time, obviously, but I have to do some work on it. But yeah, other than that, full of perennials. I also divided some of the ornamental grass, and I have it now in two spots on the balcony. I'm dividing a lot of my own plants to fill in and to have more perennials rather than annuals. I am so looking forward to fall. It's my favorite season. I can't wait to share some fall plantings and bulb plantings and compositions with you. But for now, thanks for joining me, and I will see you again in the next video. Bye.